this messy day. Really, the first messy commute day of the season, right?
We've had snow in the southern tier, and the city has kind of gotten a little taste here and there, but it hasn't been when everybody wants to get on the roads. Take a look at the picture over my shoulder. This is definitely the most wintry scene we've seen on Skywatch 7. Boy, that looks like it's going to look until probably about April. So get used to it, all right? Here we go. Let's go ahead and check out what we've got going on outside. We're at 30 degrees, but when you factor in the wind, it feels like 22. And a sunset tonight that came a little earlier than 5 o'clock. Winds out of the east at 8. At least we don't have a lot of wind blowing this around. But there are some delays by air. Autumn just showed you all the roads are slow, and we're going to continue to see that plague a lot of the destinations in and around the Great Lakes. And now as we take a look at the size of this storm, it was pretty big. I mean, that thing is encompassing all of the Northeast. Zeroing in, I want to pick up one spot right in here. The biggest issue we had was when it was coming down in sleet and maybe a little freezing rain. That still may be plaguing sections of the 90 corridor all the way down Route 520 and inland until you get to around the 219, although we're starting to see signs that there's that mix. We'd rather have it snow and not have to deal with any of that really slick stuff. Now I'm going to dive on in. Here's the 400 as you exit from the 90 and head down into Springbrook. And the Mobile Weather Lab is out there right now. This is the view as they're kind of looking up an accident that is not too far from here. But you can see the side of the road is definitely snow covered. You've got some slush in the middle and the truck's going by, but there was a report of an accident on the 400. You can see the lines right in there. So there's definitely slush on the sides of the road. Now, the winter weather advisory is in effect for all of the counties to the west, and that's until Friday morning. A winter storm warning to the east. The biggest difference between the two, the amount of this that you're going to have on the ground, and I'll detail that in a moment. Let me put the timing on it for you. There's that mix as we go through the early evening hours. Towards the end of the evening, we still may have some of that near Springville. It'll be snow up in the North Towns and near Wellsville. Now keep your eye at Allegheny County. We're going to spend a little time talking about you in a moment. All this steady stuff goes out for Friday morning, but the Friday morning commute, you're going to get the leftovers from what happened overnight, and then you're going to get the add-ons here. And look at all the different types of precipitation. Maybe a little rain, a little sleet, a little snow, and then this kind of wobbles up towards the city. Friday is going to be a very interesting day. You got to keep your head on the swivel because there it goes, right back down at about the time we catch a evening commute on Friday. That'll be a lot of fun. So here's three slick commutes tonight, tomorrow morning, and Friday evening. Then we'll settle it down just in time for the weekend. Okay, as far as where this goes on the ruler, this is going to be a broad brush. Most folks that are watching right now are going to get somewhere between 2 and 6 inches of snow. Snow blower or snow shovel, what do you want to do? Do you want to go fill the thing up full of gas and do it? Or just go out and shovel it. Your choice. Either way, it's going to be a heavy one. Now, let me show you the particulars on this. I mentioned Wellsville in Allegheny County, Route 86. This is where the healthy totals are going to come in through Friday evening. You folks down there are going to see a lot more than this. 1 to 3 from Niagara County over to Lockport, a little bit more, Batavia. And then as you get down into the eastern zones south of Lancaster along 20A, that 3 to 5. And Warsaw up on the plateau and further south, 7 to 9 inches of that stuff, because you folks may not get to switch over into liquid. The liquid that we're getting along the lakeshore is not that great, but it'll help keep totals down. As we look at the 7-day forecast, before we get there, we may get that itch. We may be giving somebody, forget the shovel, we'll give you a snowblower. We get to that inch, all you've got to do is watch and wind. Tomorrow, hopefully, we'll give this thing away. Now the 7-day forecast. 39, no big chill after this. We're going to hold it in the 30s, and then, oh, look at that. Turkey Day comes. How about a little bit of sunshine and 40 for the turkey trot? And the extended forecast beyond that gives us a little warm up even into Black Friday. Hey, the Weather Machine contest wrapped up at noon. Look at this. Highland and Windermere Elementary. Can you even, I hope you have a 65-inch TV. You can't even tell how many votes. Literally, it was a handful of votes after over 200,000 votes apiece. So what do you do? Well, you declare two winners because it's a statistical tie. And so how do you handle that with two winners? Well, you obviously have to visit both schools. Take a listen. Now, it couldn't be two places at one time, but through the magic of editing, we did visit Windermere, and we booked on down to Highland. And it doesn't matter who the votes went for, the reaction was the same. The kids are thrilled. Over 1,000 youngsters right now are partying tonight, watching us on 7 Eyewitness News. The family and friends that voted, that's why you did it. And we'll bring you more video when we bring the weather machine out to both of those schools.
It's so great. It's been quite a busy day for you.
A little bit.
Two schools. We got a little story.